families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for STEVE HARVEY.
Yeah. Yeah. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Yeah. What's happening? How y'all?
Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, STEVE HARVEY. We're going to have buckets of fun tonight. I'm telling you, man, this is going to be good. This is going to be good. So, this is the way it works. We went out on the streets of Mzamzi and we asked you some questions and we want the answers to them. Hard to know what's on the board, but very simple questions. That's all to it, okay? All the families have to do is match up those answers and they can walk out of here with some serious money. That's what it is. So let's meet the families playing today. From Mooi Kloof in Pretoria, it's the MATHOLE family. From Boksburg in Johannesburg, it's the SMIT family.
Yeah.
All right, everybody's here trying to win themselves some cash, and somebody could have a shot at the grand jackpot of 75,000 rand. If you ready to play Feud, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
All right, let's get it on. Give me Norma, give me Sonray. Norma?
Norma Swazi.
Norma Swazi.
Do you know what it means?
Do I know what Norma Swazi means?
Means, yes.
Thick and fine.
It means mother of all.
Mother of all?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. You know what my African name is?
No. What's
Matusi. I got it from the president of Botswana. Matusi. Means helper of people.
Oh, that's great. Yeah.
And your name is?
Sonray.
Sonray.
Yes.
And what does that mean?
Moon amongst the stars.
Moon amongst the stars.
Yes.
Yeah, see that?
Yeah.
Everybody got it together now. All right, ladies, let's go. We got one hand on the desk, one hand behind your back. If you think you know the answer to the question, all you got to do is hit the button. We've got the top 8 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something you do when you are naked and home alone.
Play with myself.
Play with yourself. What? Oh. What kind of game is this? That's the number one answer. If I'm at home by myself and I'm naked, what you think I'm doing? Shazri?
I walk around the house.
Walk around the house. Pass the play.
We're
gonna play. Sonray, what do you do for a living?
I run my own social media marketing company.
Oh, really?
Yes, I do.
Well, introduce everybody.
Well, Steve, this is my husband, Desroy. That is my brother, Charlton. And then we have Cheryl over there, my sister-in-law. And we have Monique, that's Cheryl's sister.
Okay, good. All right, let's go. Desroy, how you doing, man?
Good, just how, Steve?
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm a customer service manager for one of the largest fastener distributors in Africa. We keep the country together.
Oh, we keep the country together.
That's what we do.
Don't know what none of that means. Name something you do when you're naked and home alone.
I would be dancing around.
Dancing around, baby. That's my naked dance. Dancing around. Yes. Charlton, how you doing?
I'm good and you, Steve.
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm an engineer. I program a CNC machine that cuts bullets of steel.
No, but what is the bullet, though?
A bullet is like...
The bullet.
A bullet of steel can be something like that.
A piece of steel.
Yes.
A piece of steel.
Piece of steel.
Okay. See, over here, see a piece is a bullet. Let me have a bullet of that pie. The piece. I would like a bullet of booty. I just want a piece. Okay, child, name something you do when you're naked and home alone.
You cook like the naked chef.
You cook naked. Charlton, you cook naked.
Yeah, if you're home alone, why not?
Well,
food don't taste better like that. You know?
Food don't taste better when you cook. You ever fried chicken naked? You ever fried bacon naked? You must not know how to cook. You must be frying your chicken in the oven, partner. Because if you on that stove top and you drop that grease in there, pack! The bullet! Cooking! Oh. All right, only one strike. Hello, Sherelle, how are you?
Hello, well and yourself, Steve.
And what do you do?
I'm a stay-at-home mom.
Stay-at-home mom? You're married to Charlton?
Yes, we've got two kids, and that's what I love to
do. Two kids? What do you have?
Five. That's our girl, and then we've got a son who's two.
Ooh, five-year-old, she bossy?
Yes, and becoming very sassy. And
yes.
Excuse me, I've got my own way of doing things.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
well,
okay.
You know, we do too.
Yes, we do too. My husband calls it female in the raw form.
Female in the raw form?
The raw form. Before it's been, I don't know, chipped away and made.
Yeah,
more.
I'm not going to comment on that. I don't know what kind of trouble I get in for commenting on that, so we'll just leave that one alone. Female in the raw. Well, that's something to do with this question here, because we're talking about raw as naked, so name something you do when you're naked and home alone.
You're going to take a nice, long, and soothing bath.
Yeah. Yeah. A nice, long, and soothing bath. That was a good answer. That was a good answer. Monique, how are you?
I'm good and you, Steve.
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm an optometrist, so I'm out there checking everybody's eyes every day.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Really, really? How long have you been doing that?
I've been working for 2 years now.
So just... you're married?
No. I'm single. Well, not single, so but...
You're single?
Not single, though.
Is she dating someone?
Yes,
yeah, she's dating someone.
Do you like him?
Yeah, no, he's a cool guy.
Oh, he's a cool guy?
He's a cool guy.
You think he's okay?
Yes.
Well, how long y'all been dating?
We've been dating for a year now.
A year? Oh, yeah, okay. No. So where's this going? What's happening?
Well,
what's this leading to? You've been... I mean, you're an optometrist, you're a beautiful young lady, you look like a good pick, you've been dating for a year. What's happening?
Can I pass?
Nah. Nah. We want to know what the hell he waiting on. We want to know why you are dating this wonderful young woman for a year. What are you waiting on? This is the prize. What's the song called? Beyonce.
Like, you should have put a ring on it.
What is the song?
If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it.
If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. Doesn't this young lady look like she should have a ring? So here's what you do. Just say, look, I think you're a wonderful guy. I really think the world of you, and I think you feel the same way about me. But I'm going to just put this on hold until you decide, sir, that I'm who you really want.
Okay.
Because you're worth it. All right, you ready? Something you do when you're naked and home alone.
Steve, I would laser out, just laying on the couch.
Oh, just, all right. That's posing. Lays around on the couch, naked.
Yes.
Sare, name something you do when you are naked and home alone.
Watch TV.
Watch TV. Des Roy, tell me something you do naked when you're home alone.
I'd be laying in the backyard tanning.
You lay in the backyard tanning. Yeah. Laying in the backyard tanning. We asked 100 people in Mzanzi what they would do, and all them black people said, we in the backyard naked tanning.
That's a sign, man.
Thoughts in Africa.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's go. Laying in the backyard tanning. All right. All right, here we go. Name something you do when you're naked and home alone.
Changing outfits. Changing my outfits.
Changing outfits. All right, let's look at the remaining answers. Number 8. Number 7. Number 6.
Peace.
Number 5.
Listen.
Well, we got a game now, folks. The Matholi family not on the board. The Smith family got 69. Hey, listen, y'all, don't go away. We'll be back. We're playing Family Feud in South Africa, man. Yeah. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Matholi family not on the board. Schmidt family got 69. Give me Mac, give me Desiree. All right. Okay, Matt, listen, let me see. Matume.
That's right.
Desiree.
That's awesome.
Bam, nailed it, let's go. All right, we surveyed 100 people, got top 7 answers on the board. Here we go.
Do you need help there, Steve?
Name something that annoys you while queuing at the supermarket.
Crying babies.
Crying babies.
Oh. Chatterboxes.
Chatterboxing.
You gonna play? You gonna play, Steve? Thank you.
Man, yo. You know, when I came up with this whole idea, I bought the international rights to do Family Feud in Africa. You know, they said, Steve, why would you do that? I said, because I want to go home. I want to go home and work. So they said,
woo! Yes, Steve.
No, you. It's not going to be the same. I said, no, it's going to be great. It's going to be a lot of fun. And so then they started coming up with the questions that would pertain to the continent. You know, stuff in Africa, stuff in South Africa. Well, I didn't know that I wasn't going to know half this stuff. Queuing. What it's pronounced? Queuing?
Queuing.
Queuing means standing in line.
Just queuing.
I didn't know that. So. have big lips. That's hard to do. Kiwi. Because you got, this hurts. Kiwi. What do you do for a living?
I do charity work for non-profit organizations. Okay. So yeah, I'm an orphan as well. So I just took initiative to help other kids as well without parents.
All right, that's good. But Tumi, what do you do for a living, man?
I'm in IT service management. Yes. Called a configuration management analyst. So what I deal with is processes. So I gotta manage everything that you have in your process. Basically, I can manage this whole studio.
Is this a job interview?
Nope, it ain't.
And the reason we can manage your studio is while you are standing around queuing, doing nothing. Queuing you. Togo logo.
Right there. But a little subtle. Take it a little slower.
Togo logo.
Right there. Right there. Right there. You got it on the money.
Togo logo.
There you go.
On the money.
Got it. What do you do for a living, man?
I am a sales manager at an advertising agency. Basically, I could advertise a show too.
You're some. Woo.
Woo. Check me out. Woo. Check me out.
Boy, you about to blow up. Whoa. Been messing around with Steve Harvey, man. All right, let's go. Name something that annoys you when you're queuing at the supermarket.
Slow cashier. Yeah.
Slow cashier. Yeah. Magotso.
Makotso.
Makotso.
The K is silent, so
the K is silent. What you put it in there for?
My mama. My mama.
What do you do for a living, darling?
Well, I do occupational health and safety and environmental management along with logistics. So I work for like a manufacturing company.
Oh, a little smart little family over here. Okay. Okay. Excuse me. We are proper teams for engineering, for post positions. All right, let's play, darling. Name something that annoys you while queuing at the supermarket.
People cutting in front of me?
People cutting in front of you! My man, Vusi.
Yewu.
Did I nail it? Did I get it right, Vusi?
Got it right.
Nail it, baby. Yeah, I'm getting better, man. Now, you want to know why I got that? Because you look like Vusi. You know? You know what I mean? You look at him, you go, yeah, Vusi. He just look like Vusi, man. This ain't Vusa. This Vusi, man. This Vusi. Vusi, what do you do, man?
I'm in construction, Steve.
Oh, okay. Yeah. What type of construction?
Civil.
Build? Civil? Like yes. Build houses? Oh, roads.
Roads. Yeah, on roads. The roads, yes. We
okay.
Do pipes and stuff.
Yeah, so, I used to do that, man.
It's quite nice.
Yeah, right, really. Quite hardest nice. Damn job I ever had.
No, I just had to tell people what to do, so.
Oh, you the supervisor? Oh, yes. 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 Yo, pick that up, take it over there. Now pick it back up and take it back over there. Are you ready? You ready? Pick it up again. This time, take it right here. Now take it back over there. My job is easy. I am a supervisor. I was never the supervisor, Lucy. I never had a job where I was a supervisor. That's why I was not a good employee.
Wow.
Yeah, I was never a good employee. You know why?
No.
Because I never met anybody that I thought should be in charge of me. That's my problem. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you feel that way, but I just never thought anybody should be in charge of me, man. I always had an entrepreneurial spirit. I always wanted to be my own man. I didn't want no boss. I don't need nobody telling me what to do. Let me figure it out. Let me hustle and grind. Vusi, name something that annoys you while queuing at the supermarket.
Being told that I'm in the wrong queue.
In the wrong queue? Only one strike. Name something that annoys you while queuing at the supermarket.
Heat, Steve. Heat.
Oh, well, that's your... That's your fault, girl. You the one over there, you wore that little tight outfit. Standing in line now, you hot. Hell, everybody hot. Girl, I'm just standing here. It's hot. All right, we got two strikes now, Mtume. Hey, you can still get ready. Name something that annoys you while you're queuing at the supermarket.
People with bad odor, Steve. Bad odor.
People that stink. Togolo.
A little slower.
Togolo.
Right there.
Name something that annoys you while you're queuing at the supermarket. You got two strikes, gotta be careful, they can steal.
Okay, cool. Finding that I've got an item that has an expiry date and I've been waiting for so long.
Finding out that you have an item that has an expiring date and you've been waiting so long.
And I gotta go back?
Well, that long-ass answer ain't gonna be up there.
Bitch, Michelle.
Dude, look at that line, boy. We can't put all that up there. Standing in line with an item that I've been waiting on for so long that has an expiration date on it. Name something that annoys you while queuing at the supermarket.
Well, when someone coughs on me, someone who's sick.
When someone coughs on me. Number 7. Six. Two. Everybody, we got a game now. Matter Holy family got 54. Schmidt family got 69. Don't go away after the break. Our families are gonna be playing for double the points. We got a good one today, y'all. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game, y'all. Matt Holy family 54, Schmidt family 69. Give me Tagalogo, give me Shanti.
That's one, sir.
Let's play Feud. We surveyed 100 people, top 6 answers on the board. In South Africa, why would someone say, yo, yo, yo?
To greet them.
To greet them.
And you're shocked?
When you're shocked.
Yeah, like, yo, 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 yo. We're playing, Steve, we're playing.
Ooh, 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 ooh. Okay, so, okay, so how should I have said it?
Yo, 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 yo.
Yo, 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 yo. Yo, yo, yo. I did. Yo, yo, yo. I'm learning. What can I tell you? Yo, yo, yo. Yo, yo, yo. I got it. That's that swag. I'm black. I got it. It's in here. I got it. All you got to do is tell me what it is. It's in here.
Coco.
Coco, call you Coco?
Call me Coco.
Cool. Cause my head was starting to hurt. In South Africa, why would someone say, yo, yo, yo?
When they're laughing at you.
When they're laughing
so
at
funny,
you.
It's so funny, it's like, yo, yo, yo.
Vusi,
yeah,
in South Africa, why would someone say yo, yo, yo?
If there's trouble.
There's trouble.
Yeah.
There's trouble. Normal in South Africa, why would someone say yo, 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 dog?
Steve, it happens to me all the time when they see a big booty.
They see something. They see something wonderful. But to me, in South Africa, why would someone say yo, yo, yo?
They got robbed, Steve. They got robbed.
They got robbed.
Yeah.
You get robbed, and you say, wait, hold on. Yes! And we all been robbed. Yes. You are going to be robbed too. Yes! No, 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 no. I'm gonna be watching. When you're getting robbed, all right, only one strike. Tug logo.
Can I make it simple for you, Steve?
You make what simple for me?
Calling my name out. Like, I got a nickname.
Oh, you got a nickname?
Yeah, I want to stay in the township.
Oh, hell,
so...
I was nailing yours, so I don't know
you can imagine
why me. I need a nickname now. Tug logo. I've been nailing it. But now you want a nickname. What is it? Let me... Togo.
Nah. That's actually Tuki.
Tuki?
Yeah.
Oh, Tuki.
Like Tuki Williams.
Former like Tuki Williams?
Yeah.
Tuki Williams the Crip?
Yeah.
But you want to be named after
Williams.
Tuki Williams
no.
the Crip?
No.
Tuki Williams was one of the famous Crip gang members that started the Crips in Los Angeles.
Yes.
That's who he's named after. Little Tugalogo is. Little Tugalogo is named after a Crip. Oh, he actually did really well at the end of his life. He was up for a Nobel Peace Prize for writing children's books in prison. Wow. Actually turned his life around. All right, Tuki. South Africa, why would someone say yo, yo, yo?
When we happy.
When you're happy.
Yeah.
When you're happy.
I tried.
Well, let's stop all that happy mess. Yo, 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 not up there. But we got to be careful now. We got two strikes the other family can steal. In South Africa, why would someone say yo, yo, yo?
To warn you that there's some danger maybe behind you or something. Like, yo, yo, be careful there. There's something there.
There is danger. Yo, yo. Yo, 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 look out. All right, in South Africa, why would someone say yo, yo, yo?
When you see a car accident.
When you see a car accident. When you see a car accident. Number six. Well, that's round three, everybody. We still got a good game. The Matholi family got 54. SMIT family, 205. Don't go away, cause after the break, we're gonna be playing for double the points, everybody. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Boy, we got a good family banging out gang up here today. MATHOLE Family 54, SMIT Family 205. Give me Coco, give me Sherelle. All right, everybody, in this round, the points are doubled. We surveyed 100 people. We've got top five answers on the board. Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
Church.
Church.
Hey, Monique.
Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
At a funeral.
Yes, good answer, good answer. Good answer. That's a good answer.
At a funeral.
Yes.
Sound ready? Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
In a hospital.
In a hospital.
Good answer.
Desroy, only one strike. Name a place you might get in trouble if you laugh.
If you laugh in an important meeting.
Laughing at an important meeting. Only one strike, Carlton. Here we go, man. Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
At the dentist.
Let me ask you a question, Charlton. I'm assuming you've been to the dentist before. What the hell was funny at your damn dentist? You're laying back. He got his hand in your mouth. Yeah, have you ever had a tooth taken out?
Uh-uh.
Oh. Oh, it ain't funny. It ain't funny. All right. The dentist! All right, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful, Sherelle. The other family can steal. Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
In a courtroom.
In a courtroom. In a courtroom. Well. Look who has a chance to clear the board.
Sure. No pressure.
No pressure. Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
I'm going to say in an exam.
In an exam. In an exam. All right, let's go. Name a place where you might get in trouble if you laugh.
In a library.
In the library. In the library. Number three. All right, listen to this. This is the last round. Now, MATHOLE family, with only 54 points on the board, you can't win the game, but you still have a chance to walk out of here with a lot of cash. Okay? Everybody on Family Feud has a chance to win cash. So for every point you get in this round, we're gonna multiply it by 50, and you're gonna walk out with the cash, man. Let's get it on! Give me Vusi, give me Monique. All right, guys, in this round, points are triple. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 5 answers on the board. Here we go. Name a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
Cell phone.
Cell phone. Okay.
Don't
play. Sorry, name a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
A DVD player, Steve.
The DVD player. Desiree, name a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
Give me a laptop, PC.
A laptop, PC. Charlton, give me a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
Smart TV.
Smart TV.
Yes, yes.
Sherelle, only one strike. Give me a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
An air conditioning system?
Air conditioning. That brand new invention called the air conditioner. Only one strike, Monique. Name a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
I'm gonna say a smart car.
A smart car. Yeah. Name a modern device that confuses your grandparents.
Microwave.
Woo! The mic, wow. Microwave! Number 4. 3. Well, let me tell you something. The Tolley family, I had a good time with y'all.
We had a good time too.
Y'all played really, really well. And for your efforts, you're walking out of here with 2,700 Rand. And you just won yourself KFC for a whole year worth 10,000 Rand. So your family can share Kentucky Fried Chicken the whole year while you're sitting around watching Family Feud. Hey, SMIT family, who's gonna play Fast Money? I need 2 of you. All right, I got Sherelle, I got Sherelle. When we come back, we're gonna play Fast Money for 75,000 Rand, man. Welcome back to the feud, everybody. The Schmidt family won the game. Woo! And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, everybody, here's how Fast Money works. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. And if we have enough time left, I'll get back to it. Okay? Then if you and Sean Ray together come up with 200 points, look right there. Tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75,000 Rand!
75,000 Rand! All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name someone in your life you wouldn't want to see giving a lap dance.
My mother.
Something people struggle to open.
An envelope.
Something people steal from a hotel.
Soap.
A body part you can wax.
Your legs.
A specific event that takes place in a stadium.
A soccer match.
Bam! Yes, yes, yes. Good, good. All right, let's go. All right, Sherelle, let's go. Name someone in your life you wouldn't want to see giving a lap dance. You said your mother, survey said.
Yes, yes.
Something people struggle to open. You said an envelope, survey said. Something people steal from a hotel. You said. So, survey said. Yes. A body part you wax. You said. Leg. Survey said. Yes. A specific event that takes place in a stadium. You said. Soccer. Survey said.
Yes.
Boom. There you go. Good job. All right, let's clear the board. Let's bring out Sean Ray. Come on, Sean Ray. Well, Sean Ray, Sherelle did pretty good. She got 115
really?
Points.
Wow.
You need 85 points.
Oh, you can do it.
And if you get it right, 85 points, you could walk out of here with 75,000 rand. All right. All right, this is how it works. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's remind everybody of Sherelle's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. All right, the clock will start after I read the first question. Name someone in your life you wouldn't want to see giving a lap dance.
Your grandfather.
Something people struggle to open.
A mayonnaise jar.
Something people steal from a hotel.
Soap.
Try again.
Lotion.
A body part you can wax.
Your legs.
Try again.
Your upper lip.
A specific event that takes place in a stadium.
Soccer match.
Try again.
Rugby match.
All right, let's go. All right, here we go. We need 85 points for 75,000 rand. Name someone in your life you wouldn't want to see giving a lap dance. You said... Your grandfather, survey said. Mother was the number one answer. Something people struggled to open, you said. A mayo jar, survey said.
You can still do it.
Number one answer was canned foods. Canned food. We need 72 points for the money. Something people steal from a hotel. You said? Lotion. Survey said?
No. Oh, my Lord.
No. Number one answer? Towels.
Towels.
Towels was the number one answer. I've stolen a lot of those.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. I had a trunk full of them.
Okay.
We need 72 points. Come on. A body part that you can wax. You said. Why would I do that? Upper lip. Survey said. Number one answer. Armpit. Your armpit. It's tougher than it looks, folks. Name a specific event that takes place in a stadium. You said a rugby match. South Africa is the world rugby champions. It's the Springboks. Survey said. Soccer was the number one answer. Well, sorry about that, but we're gonna triple your points for a grand total of 51,000 rand. I'm Steve Harvey, everybody. We'll see you next time. Hope you had a nice time. Yeah, good time. Man. Yeah. soccer armpit. That's the one. You could have got that. Hope you have a nice time.